Okay, today we're going to be replacing an idle air control valve on a 2000 Dodge Durango with a 5.9 liter V8 engine. And the steps described in this video should be good for most of the 5.9 liter V8 engines that you find on the typical Chrysler products, such as the Dodge, Plymouth, and Chrysler's V8 engines. The idle air control valve sits right behind, on top of the engine, behind the throttle body. And you gain access to it by simply removing the throttle body cover, like so, and this is it right here. And it's held by two torque screws. The idle air control valve is this unit right here. And we'll pull the connector, simply pull on the connector clip. It comes off, and we're going to be using a multimeter to test it. Now we got a code, a P0505 code, which means that the idle air control valve is malfunctioning, but we want to make sure that that's what it is, and we're going to test the circuit. And you'll need a multimeter for this. And it's an inexpensive multimeter you can get. And we'll set it on our DC scale, 20 volts. And we're looking for a 12 volt supply voltage. And we're going to turn the key to on, to the on position. Do not start it, just turn your ignition key to the on position. So do not start the engine. And all we need is to get a good ground on your negative lead on your multimeter, and any suitable good metal part on the engine. With your clip to the on top, the middle right connector, you should get around 12 volts, and we got 12.04, 03, so that's good. And on your first connector on the left, you also got the same 12.03, so that's a good sign that our circuit is working properly. And it's held by two screws. They're Torx screws, and it's a T20 you'll be using. And this will make the erratic idle, especially in when with a cold engine. On a cold start, when you first start it up, like in the morning, it'll especially would most probably make it rough enough idle that the engine might even stall until it warms up. And these are the screws you'll be taking off. They're both the same size, and this is the idle air control valve. It's around $40 at your local parts store. Okay, and upon inspection, you can see this is quite a bit of gunk in there. You may want to use some carburetor cleaner. Okay, so we'll be replacing now the with a new idle control valve. You want to tighten evenly? And we'll replace our connector. Simply push it in. Make sure it clicks in. That's pretty much it. Hopefully this video was helpful. And don't forget to subscribe and like us. And as always, try to stay clean. Just try.